to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this sweetheart neckline crop top. And the first thing I did here is, so you're going to be needing maybe like 1.5 yards. 1.5 yards is even too much, but just cut out 1.5 yards for the tutorial. You might end up not using it the whole thing. So the first thing you're going to do is to cut out your cape. So this is going to be my cape here. As you can see, I have two of it and it's folded into two, right? So you need to cut out as much as you will need. So you can use your off shoulder measurement, like round your off shoulder measurements times 3 or times 2.5, and that will be the width of the fabric you're going to be using. And the width I'm using is 108. So if you, as you can see, I have my fabric here, and this is what I'm going to be using for my cape. And then the length of my cape here is, that's including my seam allowance, is 12.5. 12.5 is the length. So it depends on you, the length you want your cape to be. So I'm using 12.5 here, but remember, I'm still going to use 1 inch to fold the end here and 1/2 inch to attach it to the top part here. So it depends on you, the length you want to use it. So now we'll talk about the body. So you're going to cut out the body you're going to be using. So first, we're going to start with the front panel. So this is what I'm using for my front panel. So guys, this is what I'm going to be using here. So as you can see, it's folded into two like this. So I just drew this in here just to show you guys that it's going to be an off shoulder. So you basically have to measure from your shoulder to where you want your off shoulder to start. So for me, I'm going to be using about, let's say, 6 inches. So I came down like 6 inches. It depends on you how you want yours to be. So I came down 6 inches, and that's where my body is going to be. And then you're going to measure where you want the tube inside to be. Remember, it can be up to your waist, or it's, because it depends on the length you want the inner crop top to be. So for me, I'm going to be using about 15 inches, because my shoulder to waist is at 17, but I want the inner crop top to stop at 15. So I added 1 inch of seam allowance, 1/2 inch for the top part, 1/2 inch for the bottom part. So that's why I have 16 here. So so which means my top is going to start at 6 and end at 16, so somewhere here. So I have to cut off the excess. So guys, that is it for calculating the length of the crop top. So now we are going to calculate the width. So the width you're going to be using here is just your bust measurement divided by 4. An extra 3 inches of seam allowance on is what you're going to need. So your bust measurement, for me, my bust measurement is 42, right? Divided by 4 is going to be 10.5, plus extra 3 inches, that's going to be 1, 2, 3. So I'm supposed to have like 13.5 here. That's going to be my fabric unfold. So guys, this is going to be the top part here, my bust part. This is going to be the waist part. So I'm going to come down to the waist part, divide my waist measurement by 4. The waist I'm working with is 36, divided by 4 is going to be 9, plus extra the same 3 inches again. And then this 3 inches is my seam allowance that I'm going to be using. So that's going to be 9 plus 3, that's going to be 1, 2, 3, so 12. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to mark it here. And I'm going to blend it in a straight line all the way to this angle. Blend it all the way up. So I'm going to go ahead and cut off this excess. So guys, now that you've cut it out, you're going to fold this part here. And you're going to go ahead and divide your nipple to nipple measurement by... you're going to divide your nipple to nipple measurement by 2. So for me, my nipple to nipple measurement, that's your breast point, is 8, divided by 2 is 4, plus extra 1 inch is going to be 5. So now that I've folded it, I'm going to make sure that I have 5 inches on this fold, this top fold here, all the way up, all the way down. And then you're going to just press it out this way. And then you're going to go back in, place your tape where it was before, which is for me at 6 inches. That's where your shoulder is. So you're going to come down from your shoulder to your breast point. For me, that's somewhere at... So guys, I'm going to put in my shoulder to my underbust, which is at 11.5. I'm going to mark that here. And sorry, 10.5. And then I'm going to check again my shoulder to my underbust, which is going to be at almost 14 inches. And then the next thing I'm going to put in is now my shoulder to my waist, which I'm going to just use the end of this cloth, which is at 16, somewhere here. So the next thing you're going to do is to subtract 1/2 inch at this lower line. I'm going to mark 1/2 inch here from this end to this point. And then I'm going to subtract 0.075 on this second line here, which is my underbust line. And then on this one here, which is my breast point line. I'm not going to subtract anything. I'm just going to connect this to my under bust line. Connect this one down to the 0.5. And then on this top part here, I'm going to subtract 1 inch from this here. This, I'm going to go in 1 inch here, and then I'm going to blend this in this way. And then come in here. This is now the point where you decide your V. So the V, if you want, you can use 2 inches deep, or just measure from your shoulder to the depth of the V that you want. So remember, my top starts at 6, right? So it depends on me how deep I want my V to be. So my V might go all the way to 8.5. So from this point to 8.5, so that's going to be like extra, almost 2.5 inches deep V is what I want. So now you're going to connect it to this point here, right? And then you're going to put in your, what you're going to use as your armhole at this side. So I'm just going to come down by 2 inches, because you don't want it digging into your skin. I'm going to come down 2 inches, or if you want, you can still use the same 2.5, but I'm going to use 2 inches. That will be okay for me. So from this point now, you're going to blend this, raise this up and blend it all the way to that angle too. That's this junction here. You're going to blend it in. So that's basically it. We finished marking out all our bodies for this front panel. So now it's time to cut it out. You're going to start here, go in here, go up to the breast point. And then from this breast point now, we are going to also cut it this way, cut off this excess here, and then separate it. And then we are going to cut out our V this way. So this is the neckline here. And then we are going to, so you see, at this point now, we have our center panel. So this is the center, this is the V. So now we are going to cut out this excess from our sleeve. Our armhole part is what we are going to cut out now. So we're going to go ahead and cut this one all the way to this point. So now you see we have our side panel. So basically now we've cut out what we need for our bodies here. This is our bodies now. So now we need to, that's the tube underneath our dress. So now to cut the back panel of this, our tube, we need just the side. Just the side, because this is the side, right? We need just the side, because the only contact this back panel has with the front is just this side. So you're going to cut out another fabric again. The length is going to be determined by, the length is going to be determined by the length that you have by the side of your, by the side of your top. So the length I have here by the side of my front panel. So the length I have here is about, so I'm going to measure what I have. I have 8 inches. So my top for the back is going to be 8 inches of length. So after that, now we are going to talk about what we use as the width. So your fabric is folded again. The back panel is folded again into two. So what you're going to do now after folding it is to divide your, to determine the width here, you're going to divide your bust measurement by 4 and add 2 inches. So for the back, you're going to be adding 2 inches. Our zip is going to be on the side. If our zip was going to be at the center, we would have used 3 inches. But since our zip is going to be at the, we could have used 3 inches more if our zip was going to be at our, at the back. But I'm going to be inserting a side zip. So now you're going to divide your bust measurement by 4. So for me, that's about 10.5 plus extra 2 inches. That's going to be 12.5. So somewhere here. And then you're going to go ahead and divide your waist. So this part here is going to be my waist. My waist measurement divided by 4 is going to be 9. Plus extra 2 inches is 11. I'm going to mark that here. And then you're going to connect your bust to your waist to your bust this way. And then you see, now I'm going to cut this part out. And then using this line, before I cut it out, using this line, I'm going to just stretch it across. So that I know that this is my length. This line that I made before, I'm going to just stretch it across here, this way. This line that I used to mark the side that I marked here before. So just stretch it across, and now you can go ahead and cut it out. So I'm cutting everything out now, and then I'm going to cut it across too. So guys, now we finished cutting. So the only thing left now is start coupling everything together. So this is our back panel. You see, what you're going to do for the back is just to go ahead and give it a dart. So you're going to dart it one here, and then you're also going to dart it one here. So that's the only thing you're doing for the back panel. If you want, you can use lining and also use padding. But for me, because the cape is going to be covering the top, I don't think I'm going to be using anything inside of it, because this the cape is still going to flap over. You don't want to get too hot inside of the cloth. So I'm just going to use the pattern alone. And then the next thing you're going to do is my front panel. All I have to do is to join the two sides like this, right? So you see, I have opened up and I put the two sides close to it. So all you have to do is to take one here, right side facing each other, join it like this down. Take this one, right side facing each other, join it like this down, and then you have your top panel, your front, sorry. See, I've gone ahead and joined my bodies. I just closed the side for now, but I'll still open it up later and put in my zip. But the next step is just to go ahead and mark 3 inches distance from the side seam to the front here, 3 inches distance here, right from the armhole, coming 3 inches and mark it. I also did the same thing at the back and I marked it. This is where my gather is going to stop before it goes into the sleeve side. So this, I'm assuming this side to be my armhole. So coming 3 inches, if you are more on the smaller size, then use like 2.5, that will do. So the next thing I also did is to go ahead and I joined my cape. So this is the cape here. And as you can see, I closed up the two sides. So guys, as you can see, the two edges are closed this way. So it's just like this now, the way it's going to be attached. So now you also go ahead and mark the center. So I marked the center, and you see, I made sure that my two seams are going to be at the side. There's one seam here, and then there's another seam here. These are the seams that I used to close up the edges here. So you see, So guys, you see this here, I folded it into two and then I notched the center here. So you see, I notched the center for both the front and the back. So now when I open it up, this is the center. I'm going to take it the way it is now. I'm going to take this top here and put it inside of it this way. So what I'm going to do now is to take this part here. I'm going to take it like this and gather it all the way around this neckline. So I'm going to follow this neckline this way, starting from this mark that I made here, which is the distance of 3 inches from the armhole. I'm going to gather it all the way down to this neckline, all the way back to the other 3 inches. And then I'm saying is that this 10 inches distance that I marked from the edge of this here, from this edge here, is going to be inside of my armhole. And then from this point to this notch that I made here is going to fit in from this 3 inches to this point. So I'm going to make sure that I gather this on top of this. The same thing is going to happen at the back. So guys, as you can see, this is it here. So you're basically going to pleat the gather on top of your bodies, because if you look underneath it now, you see this is my bodies here. So you see the bust part here, this is my tube. But then I just took the gather and then I followed the neckline and I was just gathering it on top. So you see where my V goes down. So I got to that part, then I went up back again and then down to this point. So after that, you have that 10 inches that I told you guys. So you're going to have a distance of 10 inches before where this top starts. That's before where you got to that 3 inches inside of the tube, right? So you have 10 inches distance on each side. So now this is what you're going to do with that 10 inches, because that 10 inches is going to contain elastic. The rest of this part here, we're going to finish it up with bias, but you can't use bias on the sleeve also. You're just going to use make a casing and then use elastic inside of this here. So elastic is going to pass through this here and then it's going to attach at this point. So this is how you're going to do it. So when I finished sewing it, I had just this piece of I just had this 10 inches here. So all I did is just to cut out like a strap of about, let's say, 1.5 inches here. And then I attached it to this case. I attached it to this 10 inches all the way around to the back, because there's 10 inches in front, there's 10 inches at the back. After attaching it, I'm going to just fold it like this. So you see, I attached it from the inside, right? So now I'm going to just fold it this way and make a casing. Like fold it all the way around to the back and just sew it down. So this is the tiniest elastic that I'm going to be using here. So this is where I joined it. So if you look closely now, you will see that inside of it is my bodice, right? You see my tube is inside here. Let me raise it up so you see. This is my tube here. So you see, this is the tube inside of it here. Let me pull it aside. So this is the tube inside. But if you look on top now, you see that my casing is just on the gather part, right? See, my tube is still on itself here. See my tube here. But you see, my casing is just on this elastic part, on this gather cape. part. So you see where it joins to the so this is my bodice here, the main tube. This is the casing of the cape here. So this is where I'm going to just take it this way, fold it on top of this cape itself, right? It's not going to attach to this. The only time it's going to attach to this is when I pass my elastic. I'm just going to, after I pass my elastic and it comes through this loop to the other end, I'm going to drag it and just top stitch it on top of this. Then now I'm going to top stitch it to the main bodice all the way in front and the back. Just put the elastic enough that you need, like this one. Now all I have to do more is just to pass my elastic from this opening here and then come out at this back here, and then I'm going to drag it. Once it's enough to what I need, I'm going to just top stitch it, hold it down with this bodice at the back casing that I've made on this cape. I'm just going to start from this side and run a bias, and then this is going to be attached down this way. I'm going to make my bias pass on top of it all the way and get to the other side. So that's basically how I'm going to do it. I'm going to go ahead now, finish up the casing on this side, pass my elastic on the two sides. I've done that. So you see, I'm showing you guys now, I've attached the elastic. So you see where the elastic meets this part here on these two sides. So you see my elastic meets this top part here, and it's also the same thing on this side. So you see, this is what it looks like where it meets. So now I'm going to start putting in my bias, because I can't just put bias on the top layer. I have to put bias because remember there's still this piece here going through the underarm. So you see there's still this side here, so I need to run my bias round from this part. So to do that, all I have to do is to take my cloth. I'm going to start from the inside where I join my two sides. So you see, this is the inside seam of my main sweetheart neckline bodies. I'm going to start, this is where the two side seam starts, meet each other. So at this point, I'm going to start from one of them and then place my bias this way on top and keep sewing it. So when I get to this part where I join the elastic, I'm going to try to make sure that I use my bias to cover it, so that once I flip it over, it will look clean like this, right? It will look clean like this. So I'm going to take my bias and run it round the neckline until I get to the other side of the armhole inside of this cloth, and then I'm going to cut it off. After that, then I can open up my side seam and put in my zip. The same thing is, you're going to run the bias separately. You run the one for the front separately, and then you run the one from the back separately. Also for the back, you're going to start from where your bodice is. Let me show you guys the bodice I'm talking about in case you don't know. So this is the bodice here, right? The top part of this bodice here, this is our sweetheart neckline. The top part of it is where we are running the bias. But remember, there's still this part of it here. You can't just run the bias on top of it and forget about this part. Although it's inside of your cloth, but you need to run bias on it also. Like this inside part here, you need to run bias on it also. So start from this part here and run it until you get to where this part crosses over. That's why I said to sew down your elastic, so that you don't make mistake when you get to this point or you start struggling with the elastic being inside, so that you can just cover the elastic and this part one time with your bias and keep sewing all the way down. I'm going to now rip this seam open and then put a zip that is going to be facing down. Don't make your zip go up, no. Make your zip face downwards like this, right? You know, normally you zip up this way. No, for this, you're going to be zipping down wet. So make sure you don't forget that.
Guys, you see what mine looks like? I used, instead of folding the bias, I just left it on top. So your bias is supposed to run on top all the way like this. So you see, it's not the type of bias that you fold in. So let me bring it down so you guys can see. It's the type of bias that will give you this thickness at the top here all the way. And then you see the cup below. You see the cup for your bust. You see the cup for your bust on this side. So this is the top. You see how this end is here. And then by the side, I have my zip here. Inside here. And then on this side too, the bias runs all the way in here. And then this side has just seam. This side has just seam. And that's here. And then there's elastic at the two ends. And then elastic at the two ends here. So that's basically it here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. And bye.